Oh. It's always a pleasure to have our friends from Kwantlen First Nation to drum us in and to give a message of inspiration at the front. Of course, Stenberg College is proud and humble and grateful to be located on their ancestral lands. And just want to acknowledge them once more and thank them for that that message. My name is Jeremy Sable. I'm the president of Stenberg College. I'm your master of ceremonies for this evening, for this evening's graduation ceremony. At the fall graduation, it's a bit of a special version of our grad because we have our Student of the Year awards. We'll be doing that this evening as well as the valedictorian presentation. Just a few notes before we plunge in here. I'd like to thank you all, of course, for making the trip here. I know our students, years and years ago, all of our students came from the local area. Those days are long gone, and now we have students right across Canada. I know people have traveled from across the country to be here this evening, and from around British Columbia to be here this evening, either to be on stage or to be in support of someone on stage. I really want to thank each and every one of you for making that effort for this special occasion. Every year, over 1,000 students enroll at Stenberg College to transform their lives through education. For them, Stenberg represents a fresh start. For many, it represents a new lease on life. Whether students are taking classes at our flagship campus in Surrey, or one of our satellite campuses throughout British Columbia, or one of our regional labs in Calgary, and Winnipeg, or Halifax, or maybe they're participating online from somewhere across the country, their profound personal and professional transformation unites their experience. In recognition of their remarkable accomplishments, Stenberg annually presents the Student of the Year Award to a deserving student who exemplifies excellence in academics, leadership, attitude, community service, and spirit. The award goes to a student who embodies our mission to develop caring graduates who benefit their professional and personal communities. The winner receives a full tuition reimbursement of up to $20,000, and the first runner-up receives $5,000 tuition credit, and the second runner-up receives $2,500. Each program finalist receives a $1,000 tuition reimbursement as well. It is a very significant undertaking to go through the exceptional student body of Stenberg College, receive all the nominees, and then try to make an extremely difficult choice every year as to who is deserving of the Student of the Year title. We received many nominations once again this year, as we always do, from faculty and instructors, and we are once again overwhelmed by the excellence within our student body. All the nominees are wearing gold V-stoles to recognize their nomination and will receive their nomination certificate in the mail. I'd like to ask all the Student of the Year nominees please to stand at your seat to be recognized for the honor of simply being nominated. Thank you very much. I'd like to also recognize and congratulate the program finalists. When your name is called, please stand. I'm going to call out those who are not able to attend this evening. We always like to say that students are not able to attend grad because they're working. In the vast majority of cases, that's actually true. Working in healthcare means shift work. Working in healthcare, human services, and education often means shift work. And so many grads are just simply not able to attend for that reason. But from our Business Diploma Marketing Specialization Program, Fatima Robertson, not attending this evening. Cardiology Technologist Program, Jiawen or Carmen Deng, not attending. Counseling Therapist, Hannah Blackburn is here though, I believe. You can stand, Hannah, and remain standing. Early Childhood Education, Basic and Post-Basic, Danielle Chapman, not able to attend. Education Assistant, Sheila Mugford is here. Oh, you can stay standing, we'll get you at the end. Healthcare Assistant, Bimal Naidu. Hospital Support Specialist, Rachel Howie. Medical Lab Assistant, Kuicheng Carol Nyan. Optician, Gabriel Vicentin, also not attending. Practical Nursing, Justine Himeno. There we go. Pharmacy Technician, Sherry Goldie. Psychiatric Nursing nominee, Oksana Yatsik. I know you're here, Oksana. And Therapeutic Recreation, Natasha Williamson. A big hand for all of the finalists. All right. Now, from that group, we would like to congratulate and recognize and bring down to the stage for a photo and a presentation one of the runner-ups who is here this evening, practical nursing student Justine Jimeno. First runner-up, would you please come down to be presented with a plaque by Jag Tack, our nursing program director. Please come to the stage. And a pause for a photograph, of course. Congratulations, Justine. Tremendous. All right. As is always the case, the winner of our Student of the Year award is an incredibly deserving individual. When I tell the story, it has a current events connection as well. Psychiatric nursing student graduate Oksana Yatsik. As she makes her way down, yes, you may come on down to join me. Growing up in Ukraine, Oksana had a good life. As she grew older, she witnessed mental health challenges around her being ignored and became determined to support people through their mental health struggles. After settling in Canada, Oksana returned to school to fulfill her childhood dream of helping people, and she became a mental health care worker but was determined to do more and enrolled in Stenberg Psychiatric Nursing Diploma Program. She knows nurses have more opportunities to advocate and wants to affect greater change. Today, as a psychiatric nurse with a 95% grade point average, Oksana helps people struggling with mental health, addiction, and substance use. Psychiatric nursing instructor Mebs Karim says this about her. Oksana demonstrated excellent theoretical knowledge and application in clinical practice. She was a leader who assisted students who struggled. She will be an asset to the psychiatric nursing profession. Her instructor, Amber Davis, also says Oksana has a gentle energy and thoughtful kindness that is deserving of recognition. Her presence, her mere presence, has a positive impact. Please welcome Oksana Yatsik to the stage. She's already here for her Student of the Year address.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Oksana Yatsik, and I'm a graduate from the psychiatric nursing program. If someone had told me that one day I would be giving a speech accepting the Student of the Year award, I would never have believed it. And I trust people until they prove otherwise. I feel honored to have this opportunity to speak today. Today, standing on this stage, I want to recognize every student that successfully finished their program, despite any obstacles they may have faced in their life. All of us were challenged by our own fears, insecurities, and the struggles that come with being a student. We had to survive the world pandemic. We had to adjust to restrictions and isolation policies while also adjusting to the role of the student. Whether we came to school right after high school or returned to school years later, we can all relate to how difficult it is to be isolated from family and friends when you need them the most. Each student should be proud of themselves because despite everything, you made it. I want to say thank you on behalf of all the graduates to every teacher, instructor, and faculty member who taught us and guided us throughout these uneasy times. We are truly thankful for all the support and compassion that you showed us. My Canadian story began when I was 7 years old. Growing up in Ukraine, my dad moved to Canada for our family's better and safer future. When I was 17, the Canadian Embassy finally allowed my mom, my brother, and me to join my dad in Canada. Immigration took us years. I was scared to move, so while my mom and my brother joined my dad in Canada, I found every excuse to stay in Ukraine. At 21, I had run out of excuses and reunited with my family. So I arrived. I remember wearing headphones without connecting them to my phone because I feared small talk in this new culture. And because I couldn't understand or speak English very well. I vividly remember the moment when I realized I could not be afraid of Canada anymore. And if I wanted to be happy, I had to make a change. ESL school was only the beginning. I found a job as a security officer in a hospital, and shortly after, I realized how important this is for me to be around people, helping them. My colleagues helped me to learn not only work duties, but also culture and language. Later, I went to school to become a mental health worker. I loved being a mental health care worker, but I wanted to advocate more. And I knew that becoming a psychiatric nurse would allow me to do it. It took me years to finally push my limits and apply to Stenberg College. I did not have any hesitations about which school to attend. I knew the online program was made for me. But going back to school was still very nerve-wracking. During the program, I never once said, when I graduate. I continued to say, if I graduate. For the past 10 years, my life has been on pause. I missed many events and celebrations to be where I am today. Today, I work as a psychiatric nurse. I can be that voice of vulnerable people, especially those afraid to speak, just like me when I arrived in Canada. Tonight, we all graduate. Following your passion and your heart will take you where you need to be. Embracing this journey will bring amazing people into your life. People who you will call best friends, favorite coworkers, and people who you start calling family. I have it all now. But I would not be here if not my family. My mom and my dad gave up their lives for my brother and I to have a better future. They sacrificed everything. My dad is the hardest working person I ever known. They are the most loving and caring parents. Thank you for your unconditional love and support. I love you very much. I also want to recognize the parents and loved ones of each student here tonight. We could not have done it without you. From the bottom of my heart, I want to wish every student the best in their journey. Each of you chose this education to help others. Do not forget this feeling. And whether it is your student, client, patient, colleague, or other team member, please treat people with respect and kindness. Mother Teresa said, "In this life, we cannot do great things, but we can only do small things with a great love." I hope that each of you is now in a career that you genuinely love. Now, let's all go and do small things with great love. Thank you.
And I'd like to call forward Carly McInerney, Dr. Carly McInerney. Head of the program, psychiatric nursing program, to make a presentation and, of course, provide an opportunity for wonderful photographs to be taken. Let's have a big round of applause for Oksana. It's a fantastic achievement. And fantastic shoes as well. Blinding. Very sparkly. Wonderful speech, and one line that stood out among many for me in Oksana's address was just the simple phrase, you know, I realized that if I wanted to be happy, if I want to be happy, I have to make a change. I have to make a change in my life and what I'm doing. That just so simple, just such a simple realization, I think is probably one of the most common underlying motivators for many, maybe even all of the students that come to Stenberg College. They want to pursue something different. They have it in their minds that that pursuit is going to lead to them being happier with what it is that they're doing, happier with their life. And at some point, each of us reaches a point in our life where that question should be asked. You know, we should be making that assessment and asking ourselves, what is it that we need to do? Do we need to make a change to be happy? So congratulations, Oksana, on that realization, that achievement, and then pursuing, despite the extreme difficulty of the psychiatric nursing program, the challenge of that, staying on course and fulfilling that goal for yourself. Congratulations. The pause wasn't for applause, it was just to find my notes. That's all. We will now have our valedictorian presentation. And we have an outstanding student, once again, who's our fall 2022 valedictorian. This student excelled in her program and is our student of the year, first runner-up. I would like to introduce Justine Yemeno, who is graduating from the practical nurse program this evening. While she's making her way down, her instructor, Heidi Steves, RN, said this about Justine: the skills and attitude that she possesses are rare for someone as young as she is. She is mature beyond her years, which is evident in her compassionate care for others. Justine is the epitome of what a nurse should be. Any patient at the receiving end of her care is fortunate. Justine is the type of nurse that patients will remember fondly long after they have left the hospital. She is the most exceptional student I have taught, and working alongside her would be a privilege. Please welcome Justine Yemeno to the microphone.
Put this down. Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm Justine Yemeno, and I'm a graduate from the Practical Nursing Program. Before I start, I would just like to thank everyone for coming tonight, and the Stenberg staff and faculty for making this all happen. I am very honored to be given this opportunity to speak on behalf of my fellow graduates, and I know everyone's probably looking forward to celebrating with their loved ones, so I promise to keep this short and sweet. Before starting this program last February, I struggled finding the path I wanted to take. I felt so lost because it seemed like I was just living day by day and running out of time. This feeling was amplified when COVID started and everyone was in quarantine. It gave me a lot of time to think, and I realized I wasn't where I wanted to be in life. I didn't know which direction to go until I found nursing. Once I started this program, it gave me a sense of clarity and the guidance I was looking for. Like all Stenberg programs, the practical nursing program is condensed and very fast-paced, so you really have to work hard and be self-disciplined to study. This became even more important when classes were switched to online. Luckily, I made new friends in my cohort, and we helped each other out a lot. I don't know how, without their support, I don't know how I would have made it through the program. There were many all-nighters spent on Zoom, studying for upcoming exams, and I would be lying if I said I didn't cram for any of them. I did, like a lot, especially when there were multiple exams within a week. There were many tears shed because of stress and feeling overwhelmed, but there were also a lot of tears of joy, especially when we got that mastery email after case studies, right? Throughout my whole journey in this program, though, I felt like I had imposter syndrome. I felt like I had, even near the end of my program, because I kept doubting and questioning myself. But when I went for my clinicals and I had the opportunity to work at different facilities, such as long-term care homes, hospitals, and at a hospice, I knew I had made the right choice. I had the privilege to take care of people, get to know them, and build a therapeutic relationship with them in a short period of time. They thanked me for taking care of them and said that I would be a great nurse in the future, even if all I did for them was get them a cup of ice. These little moments reminded me why I wanted to become a nurse. And I'm sure as we all move forward in our chosen careers, we will continue to be reminded of the passion that brought us to our new careers. I want to thank my fellow classmates, the Stenberg faculty, my friends, and most importantly, my family, because I wouldn't be here without you guys. In life, there may be people who will try to tear you down, but you have to remember that this is your life, your journey, not theirs. Never let anyone dictate your future. You are the one in control of your lives and the choices that you make. If you are passionate about something, pursue it. It doesn't matter if we make mistakes. We learn from them so that we can become better versions of ourselves. If you believe in yourself and your goals, no obstacle can move you off the pathway to success. I stand on this stage today, along with my fellow graduates, because we are all celebrating our successes. All of our journeys may be different getting here, but we have all worked so hard, put so much effort into completing our programs. Tonight, we deserve to celebrate. This is just the beginning of a new chapter in our lives, and I wish you all the best of luck in what the future holds for you. Congratulations, Stenberg graduates of 2022. Thank you.
And we'll now, wait a minute, Justine. We're gonna have to bring you back. We're gonna present a plaque, of course, to the valedictorian, presented once again by Director of Nursing Programs, Jag Tak. Congratulations, Justine, on being selected valedictorian. Thank you very much. All right, big round of applause. Okay, now the moment you've been waiting for, we're gonna present some graduates. That's what it's all about. Because we have a bit of a smaller group this evening, and because we can't stop you anyways, providing applause or whatever sort of form of celebration you would like as graduates cross the stage is perfectly okay. Once again, we're gonna gather each cohort at the far end of the stage for a class picture, a cohort picture, that is how we do it. Just before we do that, I do want to say one thing. On the back of the seat in front of you, you will see a QR code. That QR code takes you digitally to a copy of the program for tonight's ceremony, but it also takes you to a copy of the Success Magazine, which is produced every year by our marketing department. It's not really a marketing piece. It's about our graduates, and it's about stories of our Student of the Year nominees. Oksana's story is in there, Justine's story, their personal life story, much more about them and their journey through the program and why they chose the career path that they did. From front to back, this magazine, this collection of real people's stories never fails to be inspiring to me. I look forward to it each year. And for all of us at Stenberg, you know, when we read it, it really is a reminder of why it is that we do what we do and why what we do really is important because it brings people together and provides an opportunity and an environment where people pursuing their passion, like Justine talked about, can really succeed and get to where it is that they want to go. So please do take the time to read those inspiring stories. I'm going to call on our alumni coordinator, Sonia Ireland, to take on the daunting task of pronouncing each and every graduate's name perfectly just before they cross the stage. Sonia Ireland has an unbroken record of 8 graduation ceremonies in a row where she has pronounced every name perfectly. And no pressure, I'm sure you will keep up that record this evening. I'd like to call upon the counseling therapist diploma graduating class. These students started in October of 2020. They're going to be presented to this evening by Laurel Tien, faculty member.
Hannah Blackburn. Katerina Ferrero. Jeffrey Hall. Jashleen Hassan. Mitra Hedaparana. Reva Jacob. Hermanjeet Mann.
Our counseling graduates will fulfill an essential role in society by helping others overcome challenges, achieve goals, and better their lives. Through their practicum at Moving Forward Family Services, a nonprofit organization providing low-barrier or no-barrier counseling services, these students have already contributed to those in need of professional support. A round of applause, please, for the counseling therapist diploma graduates from October 2020. All right. Now that we've worked out the kinks here, I'm going to call forward faculty member Jill Hammer to present to the early childhood education cohort that started in September of 2021.
Melissa Bishop. Mandeep Boparai. Kimberly Ann Capino. Hannah Christine Francisco. Ashley Hare. Lily Islas Aguilera. Anika Conrad. Karan Kumari. Martha Cecilia Nunez Tiburcio. Priyanka Rao. Avneet Sandhu. Navdeep Sandhu. And Michaela Wong.
ECE graduates can take pride in the fact that by laying the foundation for a child's future learning, they are laying secure foundations for the future of society. As children cultivate 90% of their intellect, personality, and skills by age 5, the first months and years of life set the stage for lifelong development. Calls into question what the heck I was doing before I was 5 years old. Let's have a round of applause for the graduates of ECE. 0921. We also have a group with a similar name, the Early Childhood Education graduates, this time from the post-basic portion of the program. They started in March 2019. I would like to ask Jill Hammer to remain in place to present to this group as well.
Nilofer Gunbar Zadeh Alamdari. Welcome. Mavash Hassani. Yeah. Supneet Jagdeo. Faryal Niyatsi.
These graduates have built upon their early childhood education training to further expand or further understand working with infants, toddlers, and children with exceptionalities. Post-basic grads are prepared to handle a broader range of administrative and supervisory responsibilities in childcare facilities and help instill positive values in future generations. Round of applause for the ECEPB graduates from March 2019. We're going to recognize one of our longest standing programs, been at Stenberg College for 30 years now, the Healthcare Assistant Program. This group are the cohort from November 2021 of HCA. They're being presented to this evening by Marilyn Lim Valencia.
Sherry Ballisden. Priya Chumru. Yeah. Karamjeet Hans. Megan Jackson. Alyssa Jakes. Megan Johnston. Kaylee Kent. Paramjeet Lidhar. Parminder Randhawa. Yakin Mahdi. Selena Rasmussen. Monica Singh. And Beverly Wilton.
Come on now, that's half the crowd. It's your family and friends here. Tremendous. Stenberg's longest standing program, as I mentioned, our graduates are recognized and in demand because of the skills and training they develop over their 7 months of education. Our employment rate, no surprise for HCA grads, is 100%. In fact, it is 100% for quite a number of our programs, but it speaks to the quality and reputation of their education and also the quality of people that they are. We are grateful for the work our HCA grads do. It's much talked about in the news these days that we're in dire need of more HCAs, and we appreciate their supporting elderly individuals to maintain a level of independence while easing their pain and improving their quality of life. Let's have a round of applause, please, for the HCA graduates. November 2021. And next we have our medical lab assistant cohort from October of 2021. They're being presented to, I believe, by the pair of Nicolette Barker and Coral Kalisiak. Ah, yes, a double. There we go.
Kennedy Blundell. Bailey Chung. Michelle Jen Deleon. Shiley Four Acres. Monica Gar. G.D. Jalagia. Ruby Mallow. Carolina Marto. Jamie Singson. Jamie Sarangan. And Lobsang Wingmo.
Our medical lab assistant program is excellent for anyone who loves to work with people and isn't squeamish about blood. And they're certainly a unique bunch, and chances are, if you've been to a Life Labs or anywhere else to have blood taken or get a vaccination or whatever, you've probably run into a Stenberg grad. Our graduates learn to work with various patients and develop excellent technical and interpersonal skills such as patience, empathy, and understanding, which is always good to have with a needle in your hand. To anyone in the audience who volunteered their arm while our students trained, we owe you a special thank you. Let's have a round of applause for our medical lab assistant cohort, October 2021. Also from the medical field, our medical office assistants. This group started in October of 2021. They're being presented to by instructors Nikki Cross and Harminder Mather.
Nancy Kemengeg.
Small but mighty, this cohort. Just one MOA here this evening. Medical office assistants are a part of the primary healthcare team who assist in preparing patients for physicians, surgeons, and practitioners. MOAs are known for their organizational skills and ability to multitask. They are critical to the success of medical offices. And here we have one individual who gets no less a round of applause for coming this evening. And now we're going to recognize our nursing unit clerk graduates. This group started in September of 2021. Once again, I'd like to ask Nikki Cross to come forward to present.
Andrilla Chatterjee. Harpreet Dadwal. Viola Gail Enriquez. Pavline Guman. Baljeet Kaur. Sadaf Moiz. Carly Piggin. And Kira Summers.
Nursing unit clerks are often referred to as the anchors of patient care departments. Without them, the nursing staff wouldn't be able to complete their duties in quite the same way that they do. They are extremely well organized and professional, have exceptional communication skills, and are good at managing the flow of traffic in and out of units, and managing all the various personalities that appear there as well. Let's have a round of applause for the nursing unit clerk graduates, September 2021. If you've ever been to a hospital, you've probably met a Stenberg Nursing Unit Clerk graduate. The optician cohort, OPD, from April 2021, they're being presented to by faculty member Jisu Bozkaya.
Maryam Fazel Zadeh. Ola Gazelle. Lorena Gutierrez Sanchez. Lena Kwan. Ellie Manzano. Renuka Randhawa. Archana Shirasso. Allison Sun.
Optician students combine customer service, professional practice skills, and an eye for fashion with technical healthcare knowledge. Upon completing the national licensing exam, they become integral members of the eye care team. On behalf of those who wear glasses, which includes me now, as of this year, or contacts, thank you for helping us see better in style. Big round of applause for the optician cohort, April 2021. It was a Stenberg graduate, in fact, who helped me pick out these magnificent, stylish glasses. Makes me look learned and sophisticated. Next, we have the practical nursing cohort, as I mentioned before, February 2021. They're being presented to by Director of Nursing Jag Tack. Please come forward, Jag.
Adija Akinsola. Kamalpreet Badesha. Ravina Kaur Bajwa. Janine Banting. Trisha May Kalonge. Jasmine Diol. Simrit Dhaliwal. Vianney Humal. Justine Jimeno. Varsha Reddy. Dane Sadiwa. And Jazz Corinne Savoya.
Stenberg practical nurse graduates consistently exceed both national and provincial standards on the regulatory exam and have an excellent reputation amongst employers of all kinds. Our graduates have mastered the theoretical components of nursing and the characteristics that will make them valuable in the healthcare system. Critical thinking, leadership, awareness, teamwork, empathy, of course, and the passion for delivering exceptional patient care. As with all of our graduates, desperately needed out there, and we thank you for the decision to go into a caring profession and for the excellent care you will provide as nurses. Let's have a round of applause for the practical nurse cohort in February 2021. pharmacy technician. A pharmacy technician cohort that began in September 2021, being presented to by Harini Chandrasekaran.
Brooke Araki. Sherry Goldie. Chelsea Haugen. Connor Lewis. Christine Macassette. Winter Morningstar. Brandy Knott. Grace Rammel. And Chevelli Uppel.
Well, in 2013, Stenberg's program was the first in BC to receive the status of full five-year accreditation and has gone on to establish itself with a tremendous reputation, all entirely thanks to the quality of the graduates. Pharmacy technicians are integral members of the healthcare team who prepare and compound medications. We depend on them for their accuracy, of course, attention to detail, and our overall well-being if we happen to be visiting the pharmacy. Round of applause for the pharmacy technicians, September 2021. Next is one of our programs that has students from all across British Columbia, so we know certainly we'll have some folks here who have traveled from afar. Actually, that is true of the previous cohort also. I should mention the PTD program is delivered throughout the province and has been for years, even prior to the pandemic, moving things online. So thanks to all those graduates who've traveled here. The Regional Diploma in Psychiatric Nursing, these students started in March of 2020. They'll be presented to by Dr. Carly McInerney and Charlotte Ewington this evening.
Jessica Abdelmalek. Andrea Arojo-Valim. Alicia Arnold. Arshdeep Brar. Courtney Colford. Brianne Cridland. Justine DeCock. Hillary Holman. Arveen Callan. Bincy Coran. Rebecca Lacey. Ziaran Mohammed. Brianna Nolt. Jasmine Parmar. Is this lipstick? Tessa Reimer. Braden Rosenfeld. Jeevan Sangha. Arshjot Sekhon. German Sekhon. Kyla Stride. Jatin Topsy. Kevin Turner. And Oksana Yatsik.
As they gather there, this very large group, it's worth noting that Stenberg's program is the only psychiatric nursing program in North America where theory is learned entirely online. They have graduates, as I mentioned, from all over BC here tonight. Over the past 2 years, these students have worked extremely hard to become psychiatric nursing professionals, a challenging and rewarding field that is continually in dire need of more nurses. Registered psychiatric nurses care for those with mental illness, addictions, and physical and developmental disabilities. And we are very grateful for the work you will do and are already doing in your communities. The graduating cohort from March 2020 of Regional Diploma in Psychiatric Nursing. Round of applause, please. Okay, come to our final cohort this evening. Last but never least, these will be the education assistant graduates who began in August of 2021. I'm going to ask Rachel Nicholson to come forward all the way from the Comox Valley. She's traveled to be here this evening. And she'll be presenting to the education assistant grads of 08-21.
Liesl Bentley. Baljinder Desi. Ayaka Furuiki. Marigur Malale. Shayla Mugford. Zaina Marai. Augustina Obewoma. Muskan Sandu. Oksana Smirnoff. Mary Suva. Benny Wasmuth. and Sarah White.
Education assistants work with students of all ages and abilities in various settings that require additional support with special needs, academics, behaviors, and English language learning. Graduates are equipped with additional certifications as well, which prepare them to be highly flexible and adaptable to different students in situations such as American Sign Language and Autism Spectrum Disorder. EAs make a real difference in the education system and work toward equal opportunities for success for all students. Let's have a round of applause for the education assistant graduates. Of 0821. All right, brings us to the closing portion of our ceremony this evening. Just before I make a few closing comments, there are a few other groups that require, I believe, acknowledgement and recognition. First, I'd like to say a big thank you to the team that works tirelessly for weeks and weeks ahead of some months ahead of grad to make grad happen. Most of those individuals are within the marketing public relations department, but there are others. I'm not going to name each and every one of you. There are many, but a big thank you to the group that puts grad on. It involves many other staff members as well to bring it all together on the night. So thank you to those folks. I do want to recognize the folks dressed in black and white up here at the front, the faculty and staff who are in attendance. This is just a fraction of the hundreds of faculty and staff that Stenberg College employs to make the whole thing come together here and across British Columbia and indeed across Canada. Lab instructors, monitors, didactic faculty, student success coordinators, support staff of all kinds, literally numbers in the hundreds. This representative group here, no different than the broader group, each and every one of them is involved in education because of what that education does. All of them have a passion for seeing people's lives transformed through the power of learning and then getting to apply that knowledge in a real-world setting. I am very, very privileged to be able to lead the group of professionals that we have at Stenberg College, the dedicated individuals who go above and beyond each and every day to make challenging programs happen in very challenging circumstances, particularly over the last several years with the additional pressures of COVID, as you can imagine, in healthcare and education settings. So a big round of applause, please, for the faculty and staff of Stenberg College. And this is the opportunity that the graduates now have to recognize and give a round of applause for a group of people that is represented by you folks sitting out here in the audience. Friends, family, loved ones, children, parents, brothers, sisters, boyfriends, wives, husbands. That support network that stands behind each and every one of the students up here. To one degree or another, each and every graduate is here because of support that was around them that allowed them to go through the challenges of education and moving into a new career. On behalf of them, I want to thank you, but I want to invite the graduates to give a round of applause to all these fantastic people. And now to the graduates, I want to say, I'm going to lean on the podium here. It's not very sophisticated of me, but that allows me to speak into the mic while I'm facing you. I want to say thank you for a couple of things. Number one, I want to say thank you for choosing Stenberg College, for allowing us to work with you, for allowing us to provide the environment where you did the work of learning, of gaining skills, applying those skills, testing those skills, and ultimately graduating so you could go on into your chosen profession. So I really want to thank you. I know there are choices out there. I'm going to sound a little bit like WestJet here. I know there are many choices. But you chose Stenberg, and we're grateful for that. I also want to thank you for choosing the field of work that you have chosen, the caring professions that Stenberg College teaches for, especially given that you made the choice to come into exactly those professions, those fields of practice, which were under the most strain and the most pressure during the pandemic, which apparently is not yet over. You know, you made those choices 2 years ago, maybe sometimes even further back, but you knew full well that you were going to go into hospital settings or into care facilities or into schools or into daycares where the exposure to COVID was likely to be higher. It was being talked about every day in the news. It was inescapable. So I want to thank you for your courage under those circumstances. And I also want to thank you for making the choice to dedicate your life to doing something positive, to giving back to society, to help make our society a better place, a safer place, a healthier place, a more caring society. And that choice that you've made is always extremely impressive to me. And it's inspirational and it's motivational for me and for all of the staff and faculty that work at Stenberg College as well. On their behalf, on behalf of the very many, many thousands of people whose lives you're going to touch with your work, I want to thank you in advance on their behalf. And thank you very much for what you are doing now and are going to do in the future. Everything that you do that contributes is going to make Stenberg College very proud of you as well. And I hope you'll stay in touch with us. Let us know how it's going. Connect with us and tell us your story about how it's going out there. I wish all of you the very best of luck, and thank you once again. And so if you haven't done so already, I noticed some of you did move your tassel from the right to the left. I'd like one last rousing round of applause as we move the ceremonial tassels to the left and proclaim yourselves graduates of fall 2022. Congratulations.